Hello, YouTube. I hope you're all well. Neptune Courier coming at you on Wednesday, the 5th of January. I'm sitting in the office. I feel like a newsreader. I've got my hands on the table. Anyway, I hope it's all been going well for you. I certainly, with my first New Year Christmas period on the Courier Exchange, I certainly was very surprised at how quiet it was. Everyone had said how quiet it was going to be, and I was prepared for it to be quiet. I wasn't prepared for it to be completely and utterly dead. But I was fortunate to be able to get a couple of jobs over the period off the CX, just little £40-£50 jobs here and there. And that was much appreciated from the shipper that I got that work from. So today, Wednesday the 5th, did my first CX job this year, and it went fine. It was a very fortunate day. My start job, which was off the CX, took me up to Glasgow, leaving not too far from the house. And then a job popped in not far from where I dropped off, which again brought me back down to not too far from the house. So I started at about 11:30 and I was home for 2:30. Now, as you all know, you can never earn an awful lot of money in that period of time, but I had almost no dead miles and I am quite happy. Bit of fluff left over from a COVID mask. I'm quite happy with that, and I think it was quite a good day all in all. I want to make a big shout out thank you to the Saintsman for his video where he kind of wrapped up his years, how he'd performed in the year. He had some numbers in there. It was very interesting. I kind of wish I'd seen his videos at the very before I made the plunge, because he started, I think he said November 2020. I think I started early 2021. Anyway, it's not about that. It wouldn't have changed my opinion on jumping in, but it maybe would have changed how I looked at some things and how I worked some things out. You know, it was a bit tough. You know, he talks about starting with a target of, I think, £500 a week, which he managed, then he upped it and upped it and upped it. And actually looking back through what I had done, it was very, very similar, actually. I started off not getting a huge amount of money. I think my first week was a couple hundred pounds, and then it started to go up and up and up. And it wasn't until, I think, August time, I started talking about targets, and that was just to try and help focus things for me into what I need to do to make it work. And coming up to my year end anyway, I projected forward some figures, and you know what, it's not far off where I wanted it to be. I'm never going to be super rich. I don't think anyone's going to be super rich doing this. And I think it was Rockefeller said, you'll never be truly rich until you can work out how to make money while you're asleep. And of course, if you've got 10 drivers driving for you and you go to bed and all the loads are delivered, then yes, you're going to make some, you should make some okay money or win the lottery. Anyway, rambling on. So I expect it's like a weather forecast now. I expect things to kick off a little bit better next week. Certainly, I spoke to two shippers today. Took the point of wishing them both Happy New Year. It was both two Glasgow shippers, the two people that one person I worked for today, another one phoned me up and said, look, are you working today? We have this job, which I couldn't do, which was a shame. But still, very pleased to have people phoning me up and saying, you know, either no one's bid on the job or no one has bid a price they're happy for. And my ethos going forward is to provide value for money. So, weather. So, also this time of year, you know, please do take a consideration for the weather when you quote for work. In my case, if I want to take a job, say going south, Manchester, to get there, I've got to go across two quite high hill ranges. One of them is the Beetock Summit, heading south from Glasgow towards Carlisle. And the other one is to go over the top of the Lake District on the M6. Both those patches can get really treacherous. And normally every year you hear that the police have closed this stretch of road due to snow. So in the morning, I'm getting up, I'm piling onto the CX as I always do, and I'm looking at the weather reports. I'm looking what's happening in Aberdeen, for example, what's happening in Inverness, what's happening in Manchester and Birmingham. The likelihood of me going much further south of Birmingham is pretty low. So I look at that and I consider that. And for the next few days, certainly looking at the weather forecast, I'm going to be staying local. I'm going to be staying in this southwest kind of corner of Scotland. Where it is just ever so slightly milder, it's very cold. Air temperature feels like -4, -5, I think, this morning when I got in the van, which was completely iced solid. So yeah, my plan is stay local. So please take a bit of time, consider where you're going before you go there. make sure you've got essentials in your van. Have you got extra windscreen fluid? Have you got maybe a little bit of grit in a bag just in case you do get stuck? Have you got snow chains or snow rubbers, like on my video I did last year? They're not perfect, but if you get down a road and you get stuck, chances are they can get you back onto the road. So be prepared, as the Boy Scouts would say. That's it for the lecturing, and I'll look forward to speaking to you all later. All the very best.